הלכה דלת, אקשולי הלכה וב. הרב בן ישחי צ'יצ'רזס, ואפילו הזמירו לא היה אומר רבנו הארי בגור רם. איבן דזמירות במזמורים, אריזל did not say it with loud voice. He would say it quietly. The reason behind that is because when you say Zemirot or any tefillah, you might disturb others. So one needs to be very careful not to disturb others, and Arizal was very careful about this. So, however, V'rak b'yom Shabbat haya merim golo b'ne'ima me'at yoter miminhago b'chol. However, on Shabbat, he would say the Zemirot with a more nigun, in a nice way, right, for Lichvod Shabbat, a little bit louder than usual. וכשהיה גורא איזה פסוק מתנך בתוך התפילות למיושב, היה גורא בטעמים שלו. Whenever Arizal used to say a pasuk of Torah, Nevi'im, Ketuvim, he used to say it with the ta'amim. You know, if you pay attention, the sidurim that we have, the newer versions, they have ta'amim. They have the ta'amim that how we should sing it as we go on. And there are a lot of secrets within those, ta'amim. So Arizal used to say all of those ta'amim. Right? And he was very careful. He used to always remind Rabbeinu Chaim Vital, Alav Shalom, is a student. It's interesting to know, as we mentioned before, Rabbeinu Chaim Vital, Alav Shalom, was older than Arizal. He was older. And when Arizal came to Eretz Israel, so everyone heard that there is a Gadol in Eretz Israel. And Rabbeinu Chaim Vital, Alav Shalom, did not want to go and learn Torah from him because he held himself higher than him. His Torah was from the Torah of Eretz Israel. Eretz Israel Machim. And Torah of Arizal was from Mizraim. He was from Egypt. So therefore he held that it's not the kavod of Torah for me to go and learn from Arizal. Until, if I remember correctly, I heard this from Harav Yaakov Hillel Shelita, that he mentioned, until Eliyahu Hanavi went to Rabbeinu Chaim Vital Alav Shalom and told him, look, you got to go learn from Arizal. That was one of the reasons why Arizal had to come to birth in order to learn his Torah. And the majority of the Torah sort that we have is during the last two years of Arizal that he lived in Eretz Israel, and he taught it to Rabbeinu Chaim Vital, Alav Shalom. So he used to always tell Rabbeinu Chaim Vital, Alav Shalom, don't stick your finger into your ear. Obviously, in a nicer way, right? Why? Because a person, tefillah needs to be with Kedusha and Tahara. Right? A person needs to try to make Netilat Yadayim, obviously without Beracha, before every tefillah. Chassidim are very, very zahir. They are very careful with this. They even go to mikveh, they at least go to mikveh twice a day, some of them, right? So this way you have Kedusha and Tahara. And if a person comes and he sticks his finger into his ear, then he needs to go and wash his hand or nose also, right? Or, scrubbing your, hair and touching the sweat, the scalp, right? Then a person needs to wash his hands. If he cannot do it, then he should rub his hand against his clothing or anything that has a little bit friction. That this way, he can, it can be as if he cleaned it a little bit, right? So yes, and he would always tell, look, be careful till Alenu Reshabeach, don't do it, right? And it's also written, and also whenever a person says the Yud Gimel Midot Avrachamim, right, he needs to try to count them with his hand. right, with the right hand, right, going, you know, all of that, or the Yud Aleph Samimanim of Ketoret, right? One should count them. And the reason that Harav Ben Ishchai Alav Hashalom brings here is because when you count them, you pay attention. And you remind yourself, look, there were 11 spices, right? And one needs to be very careful not to, you know, skip one of those samimanim, because this way, Chas V'Shalom, is as if he made Ketoret missing one of the samimanim. That is Asur. So one needs to be careful for this very reason, right? Ashkenazim, some Ashkenazim do not read the samimanim. They don't read the Ketoret because they are very afraid. What if we don't say one of those? So Baruch Hashem, we are zoche to say it, and when we say it with kavana, is as if that we bring Ketoret. So we need to pay attention to what we read, and we should not skip any of those samimanim. Right? Yes. The cave under him, the vajra, yeah. Yes. Okay. Is the time? Not more? Yeah, you have time? Okay. Another halakha. Kishi yagiya likriyat shema kodem parashat atamid. Now, Baruch Hashem, in Arbe Takeneset, we read all the sections before Baruch Shamar. We try to promote that. And there is Shema Israel before Baruch Shamar. So Harav Ben Ishchai says one needs to be very careful. That's in the section of Parashat Tamid, to say this Shema with Kavana, right? And the Baruch Shem Kevod also with Kavana. With Kavana Gedola, Kemo Qiriyat Shema the Yoser. Just like the Shema that we say before Shemoneh Esteh, right? So one needs to have Kavana there, that one should mechazek himself to have kavana. So Be'ezrat Hashem, HaKadosh Baruch Hu should help us that we do all these halachot properly and encourage our tefillot. Benomar, amen.